I have to admit, when the announcement came out earlier this week that the 2022 winner of the Warrior Award was Shad Gaspard, it was bittersweet, admittedly. Certainly meriting and deserving of any type of recognition like that. But it's also a reminder of the fact that Shad Gaspard passed away a couple of years ago. One of those, I look at it and say, there was nothing good that comes out of that death. There's no positive. There's no reason that had to happen. This world is just cruel and sucks sometimes. Like, you can try and put all the positive spin on it that you frickin' want, but a man who hadn't even reached the age of 40 had his life ended and isn't there with his son now. Like, there's no good, there's no possible good that could come out of this or come out of that that would outweigh the tremendous sense of sadness and loss. And it's just like it's such a senseless and unnecessary way to ultimately meet your demise. And, you know, it's unfortunate because now we think about a guy like Shad Gaspard and we think about the way he died. As much as we do think about his career and think about Crime Time and him and JTG and some of the cool things that they did and the gimmick and what they did with it. And, you know, yeah, like we could think about that too, but ultimately when it comes to Shad Gaspard, we gravitate towards how he met his passing. So while it is cool and great that WWE is honoring him, he deserves to be honored, especially when you find out about the story of how him and his son got both pulled out and were retired or whatever, and he basically told the lifeguard, save his son. So he did ultimately what you would hope any parent would be willing and ready to do if it's so demanded. You know, he sacrificed his life to save his child. I mean, you could certainly spin it that way. But then we get to the Warrior Award. And when you heard Pat McAfee and Michael Cole talk about how Shad Gaspard embodies the courage and compassion of the late, great Ultimate Warrior, like, to me personally, it made me cringe. I have to say it. It made me cringe. Now, this is tough. Because, similar to Hogan, Warrior was one of them dudes for me when I was growing up as a kid watching professional wrestling. Warrior was one of those larger-than-life comic book heroes come to life. There was a period of time that the Ultimate Warrior surpassed Hulk Hogan, for me personally. And as great as the Macho Man, and as great as Andre the Giant, as much as I love Jake the Snake Roberts and the Junkyard Dog and so many of these other talents of the past, there was only one wrestler that I could ever look at and say there was a period of time that I actively rooted for him over Hulk Hogan. And that was the Ultimate Warrior in that stretch of about 89 to 91. So as much as Vince McMahon and the WWE had this coordinated kind of hitman job that they executed for a decade plus on the Ultimate Warrior and his career and his legacy, you know, I don't forget. I know what the truth is. No matter how much pro-WWE propaganda Vince and the Titan Towers machine tried to pump out there to shine Warrior Jim Hellwig in a bad light. Now, sometimes, obviously, Warrior Hellwig did things to deserve to be put in a bad light, but it's easy when you only get one side of the story. You know, you get one side, you don't get the other. If you have both sides of the story, the truth perhaps is somewhere in the middle. But as I look at Warrior, like, from a character standpoint, from a performer standpoint, I don't know much about compassion, but there was certainly courage in the sense of he was unapologetically him. Like, he had his shtick, he had his gimmick, and he wasn't just going to fucking change that for anybody. He was who he was until he became champion, and then Vince tried to change him. But this was a rampaging ball of 200 miles an hour energy, and for those that didn't live it or experience it at the time, especially as young kids, I just don't know that you can appreciate just how big of a deal this damn dude was. So there was a courage there to be speaking in tongues and come out with the tassels and have the face paint and everything like that. Good Christ. To even have the courage to believe that you could be on a similar level back then with Hogan. That took a tremendous amount of courage. But as so often the case, is your heroes hang around long enough, they end up villains. Or you find out more about these people outside of the ring, and you say, yeah. And while certainly it was fun, you know, back a decade ago to see Warrior doing some of those rant videos about how much of a show Hulk Hogan was, sure, they were great. It also doesn't change the fact that Warrior Helwig, you know, didn't exactly demonstrate a lot of compassion for his fellow man, his fellow woman, with some of the things that he said. And this is not necessarily about him being a conservative. You can absolutely be a conservative and not say, like, racist or bigoted or sexist or homophobic things. Like, that is possible. There are plenty of people that are conservative by nature and choose to be conservative by nature for a variety of different reasons or motivating factors, and they don't have to be totally raging dickheads, penises, bitches about it. They don't have to be. It's a conscientious choice that somebody makes. And I'm very cautious of, like, nobody's going to be perfect. You put anybody under enough scrutiny, shine enough of a light on them, you're going to find things you don't like about them. I can say that about you. You can certainly say that about me. We can say that about any wrestlers, past, present, or future in the wrestling business, athletes, entertainers, politicians, your family. Doesn't matter. You shine enough of a light on them, in probably 99.999999% of those cases, you're going to find something that would be concerning to somebody. That's just life. You know, and when people talk about wokeness and cancel culture and SJW shit, like, there is certainly an element there of too much course correction. That doesn't mean that there's an excuse to prop up, support, and defend racist, sexist, homophobes, etc. Can we make that distinction? But I think we've gotten to a point where we could say, you know, the hell with Dana Warrior and what she thinks, Dana Helwig and what she thinks. Like, I understand that this is WWE overcompensating for the way they besmirched Warrior Helwig over the years. That's part of the whole reason this Warrior Award even exists, frankly, is the fact that he finally got in the Hall of Fame in 2014. He made the appearance on Raw, and by the next day he was dead. And WWE had just brought him back into the fold and felt like a tremendous sense of sadness and sorrow and guilt about that. And the fact that it took so long. I get it. But is the Ultimate Warrior the person that you really want to hold up to a high standard? This would have been, like, think of it like this. This would be like having an award given out by, let's say, the NAACP, and it's called the NAACP Best Brother Award, brother. Like, you probably would change the damn name around 2014 or so, right? It's like the O.J. Simpson Husband of the Year Award. At some point in time, logic dictates you probably don't want to commemorate him as the best of something or anything, so therefore you don't name the damn award after him anymore. Feels like there's an opportunity here for the WWE to do something a little different. Call it the Shad Gaspard Courage Award. The Shad Gaspard Hero Award. Fuck, if you want to play down the middle, call it the Shad Gaspard Warrior Award. That way the warrior thing could be more closely associated with Shad Gaspard, but at the same point in time, it doesn't totally distance yourself from the Ultimate Warrior, so that way you can kind of play that. And doesn't it feel like somebody like Shad Gaspard, and especially for what he represented, and especially with the way he passed and what it represented, doesn't it feel like that's a higher standard to want to hold yourself up to, a higher standard that others would want to live up to versus the Ultimate Warrior? I mean, I'm just saying. And I realize that WWE kind of took what Warrior Helwig threw out there and kind of bastardized it and made their own version of it, so there's that too. But couldn't we just name it after Shad Gaspard? Now, certainly you can make an argument of, Well, couldn't you do that in theory every year with whoever? Maybe, yeah, maybe you could. But maybe Shad Gaspard is the person that you want to hold up in a better light than the Ultimate Warrior. I'm just saying. Just because I was a fan of his for years doesn't mean that I have any trouble admitting that he maybe wasn't the best person outside of the ring. And the fact that some of you can't understand that distinction, the fact that some of you will just instead call me a cuck, an SJW liberal, you know, just shows the lack of basic fundamental intelligence that you have, the lack of basic ability to separate emotions from reality. I'm just saying. Feels like you're better served changing the name of the award. I know it's not going to happen. It's an incredible Hail Mary that just nothing will come of it. But what would be so fundamentally wrong with it? Like I said, if you want to play and kind of split the difference and try to please everyone, which potentially leads the avenue to where you please no one, call it the Shad Gaspard Warrior Award. Is that so wrong? Or maybe you create an award and you name it after Shad Gaspard. Like, there's another compromise right there. Like, something. So, while I am happy that Shad Gaspard will be getting a moment in the sun again on the Hall of Fame weekend, WrestleMania weekend, you know, the fact that he's getting the Warrior Award, I don't know about all that.